Sure. think that's why they don't know what's like drawing blood everywhere. But anyways, as I recall it, then, and we were only at that place once, and I recall everything, and I was just, maybe I was like four then actually. Yeah, I was four. Anyways, one thing that I remember from that, though, that isn't true, obviously, when I asked, and that's, I remember an ambulance that came and picked him up, but apparently that didn't happen. But anyways, but maybe they actually came and then left without, I mean, because probably someone needed to check his cars and everything. So that. it's a burden rather than like something to, I mean, something to aim for, yes, in a way. We all want to grow in understanding and power. And hey, baby, I'm thinking about the Bible now, suddenly about the Eden. Hey, no, and like, you know, the knowledge. Sometimes I like all those kinds of myths back in time, even whether it's truth or however, but when it comes to some of the biblical myths, let's say, also are quite interesting. And did you know that when they went into this desert to get into this promised land, I want to start singing like Bob Marley now, no, but anyways, they so much. It's like it's a double effect. It's not that it's something out there that you explore, it's like in here. Every time you like unlock something or you open a new door in that whatever story, it opens a new understanding in yourself. It deepens your connection with your own soul. That's awesome. Anyways, that it should have taken 11 days. I just recently heard that. Seen, also dreamt, like, but it, I thought it was so. least before, I don't know. I've seen them so many times now, but I don't know. They are so silly. But anyways, this Grown Up 2, I started watching, I thought no, but then again, there were quite some great actors in it also, so I started, decided to continue to watch it. And yeah, it was quite, I mean, I laughed. And also I think about us in the, I always do that when I watch sports, or if I watch a film or something, I always pull things out of there that's not really there, like with myths or so. Like I see it in a broader sense always. I do those connections always. Like when, yeah, it's like, you know, what's the, anyways, I'll just leave that, but I don't remember if there are certain sayings, you know, those, I don't know what they're called, like words of wisdom sayings, sort of. And sometimes when I listen to commentators on sports or whatever, I pick out those comments, it sounds like, but I do that in my mind, therefore I also like to watch those kinds of things myself. Not always, it's fun with others, so too, but because then I kind of go into it in like a double, I watch it as an ordinary people probably, what a person would do, I would like cheer on whatever team, or, but, and I watch it like that, and the excitement of that, but there is always this other thing going on with me, picking up things that make me understand other things better, or whatever, because it relates all the time to ourselves as humans in a broader sense, as well as this silly sort of film. I also thought of that, we are just like that, like kids coming back to our hometown, or, I mean, make-believes, like grown-ups, whomever is grown-up, and it's not something to aim for, I don't think. What is a grown-up? That's someone who left their child self behind. And also, and sometimes it's someone who have matured a bit, though. That's a good thing. And that can be good to grow in wisdom and knowledge and so on. That's actually a good thing with it. But still, to keep that. Still, however wise we are, we are like kids, you know. We have that. I guess that's also spirit, that soul in us, which never changes, although we change in years and everything. It's there, who we are. But that was not what I was going to say, but also now that there is a sentence in there which is not important, but stick in my mind. It says, they said, I don't even know 1000%. I don't know what it was. I don't even know 1000% who you are. 4000% who you are. Or something like that. What a silly sentence to say, linger in my mind, and that also feels connected to you. Somehow. I don't know. It keeps bugging me, that sentence. Okay, we'll let go, though. Didn't dream of you tonight. I don't remember, anyways. Yeah. I guess it's also because I'm kind of curious. Very curious. And so, when I don't know something, I kind of, yeah. Also, I'd like to not know, honestly. Especially certain things I prefer to not know. Alright, so. Anyways, I thought about going for a vision quest. Preferably do that outdoors in nature, to connect with nature, and also maybe fasting, but you don't need to do that all in. Even just like half. I mean, to do that to some degree would actually open you up more to the spiritual things, so. And I guess also that's when I was very sick, so I could just eat a little. That's when this whole remote viewing and so on was the clearest, sharpest. And so I think, I know I have these things and I work with them and they work well most of the time. But, or actually all the time, I guess. Sometimes I may misinterpret and so others don't understand, but it doesn't happen often.
Sense.
I shouldn't just repeat what now Rich said in his video about Jordan's rules of life or such, but some things are like the way to listen and also the way to discuss things, and they're very, very beautiful. I mean, he's talking about a deep guy. I don't know about yeah, I think Rich also must be. Especially, like, I guess there's one in particular. she tries to do to someone else who kind of attacked or did attack at least Teal quite a lot, but there are many who have done that. But she talks about the danger of it because she only fooled people kind of, all, maybe herself as well. But she doesn't talk much about herself. I mean, as an example, I mean, if you, whatever you did and you lied about that, you don't really need to, or whatever it was, you don't need to take another person as an example. You can take yourself then. She wouldn't need to talk about someone else. You could have her own example and just share that, because also even if you did, maybe others don't. Maybe others are true. You just don't know that it exists, obviously, since you blocked your way kind of through portraying yourself as something you aren't, and like lying about it. That, like, that's a good way to cut off access to it. That's also one of the things I think people stumble upon. I've talked about this several times, but I think there are many things. One is willpower. I mean, when it comes to wanting to develop these gifts that many want, especially, I guess, those, some of those who listen to me then, and, you know, if you want something, the normal kind of willpower that many use in their lives, that accomplish a lot, it's like it's the opposite in these cases working in other realms. That's, you need to relax to get in touch with a deeper, or some call it second attention, like a shift of consciousness. And then you can't have that willpower turned on, that turns the other thing off, kind of. And so, also, so you kind of need to be focused and clear and strong, but not like using that. And also to be neutral. How hard is that? Kind of impossible, but you know, at least try to not, I mean, to kind of, it's like you step out of yourself in a way. You step out of the way, you can say, even if it's just like you imagine it, it's not like you actually like in, you actually do. But you don't let your own thoughts about things and so on have the front seat, you know. Is that the Top Gun? Anyways, so you let it drift a little bit to the back and away, so that you can open that space to be receptive and not interpret through your own limits, because you also have this greater consciousness that can receive more and in ways that your left side of the brain, your logical processes wouldn't be able to. They would, if you start to try to access that. I've seen that with some of those who you do have these gifts pretty strongly, but they can't let go of their thoughts. And so they try to, there was this person, I really wonder sometimes about her aims too, but anyways, I'll just leave that. But one time we kind of did readings for each other. I don't know if we actually talked about, I think we talked about doing that. I think that's the only time I've done something like that actually, but anyways, she, I saw before and how she would do that, and I started laughing for myself because I saw what her reading would be to me, like in like structured columns, almost like in number 1, 2, 3, like that sort of thing. And I laughed to myself because I knew that, okay, she just couldn't let go of her logical mind. Like, although she do pick up and did pick up many things probably that could be correct and all that, but the need to kind of make it understandable to yourself can really limit it and also make it more obscure. feels right to each and every one. But I then cleanse with the sage, also going counterclockwise, opening the in all corners and opening all kinds of closets and doors, and so the smoke can clean out energies or residues of energy. And so when it comes to that, I clean in the space. But when it comes to certain things like objects, like I think they carry a lot of power also with them. I really don't want to cleanse them much. It depends, as I said, with the cards that I use with other people over and over, I cleanse, but it differs. But anyways, and then to fill the space with sweet grass is my favorite nowadays. I was introduced by Whispering Canadian to sweet grass quite, and I do that then clockwise, in the clockwise motion, to get that good energy in. And I love them both. I prefer natural things like that rather than ways that also are awesome for a specific purpose. And so, and if you don't have a shop like that, and also bay leaves, be careful with them though, for many reasons. I don't suggest that as a starter instance, for real. But I mean, the bay leaves themselves, to burn them on those charcoals, you can for the purpose of incense burning. But yeah, for a while, also when I was younger, when I started out, I used real charcoal, can you believe? And also I had it indoors sometimes. So I mean, when I moved from that place where I lived, when I did like those witchy things and whatnot, not only did I almost destroy the balcony, as I mentioned before, when I burned all the photos of my ex there. Yeah, I just laugh about that so much. Aside from one that I kept. Can't let go easily. But anyway, so, and also, I was so mad, I guess, and I really want to get rid of that energy. And oh, but I wish I wouldn't have burned them, though. I mean, it could have been a fun memory. I think you have maybe copies of those, probably those photos still, but himself. So they still exist, maybe. But anyways, I guess I was kind of attached to those. I loved those photos so much, so I really wanted to cut that and cut the cords. But also I had some other, when I did some ritual, meanwhile I was a Imbolc, where I had lots of candles, like the small candles, but I didn't put anything under it. I filled the room almost with candles all over the floor, and yeah, that was awesome. I love that. But then again, I didn't think that when they burned out, it was just one or so, because I did snuff them before, but made like those marks in the carpet, so I had to change the carpet when I moved out. And also when I cleansed, you know, it couldn't have been good for the lungs. I had to, like, when I, you know, was going to cleanse off the doors of the closets and so on, just, it was like black. So don't use real charcoal indoors. Actually, I have a toothpaste with charcoal and Icelandic moss, and what it is from the health store. And actually, it really, I've tried sometimes those whitening toothpaste or whatever, but this one really, it should be for that purpose, and it really works. But then again, I had got a that's active.